This is a properly new model, a seismic shift in Daimler terms. Codenamed C257, it's based on the latest Daimler Group re-engineering architecture, rather than a mere refresh of an old platform. But you guessed that much from the first official pictures, right? The new photos released at the LA Motor Show present a different look and feel, for sure. It's the latest iteration of Merck's new Sensual Purity design language, an attempt to give all new models a family look characterized by simpler form language, strong graphical anchor points, and a cleaner surface treatment. Is it as eye-catching as the MK1 CLS from 2003? Probably not, if we're being honest. But this is a striking design. Think slinkier Mercedes E-Class and you're bang on the money. Just do away with some of the original's banana stylistics, the gangster swagger. It's a slippery shape, two Merck quotes a drag coefficient of 0.26, to boost economy, emissions and quiet hush at a cruise. The oily bits underpinning the new CLS are shared with the E-Class 'twas ever thus, remember. That means a default rear-wheel drive platform dubbed RA, with the option of all-wheel drive on many model variants. This is the first 5-seater CLS, with a new additional pew between two rear armchairs. Starter engines at launch will be Mercedes' latest inline family of straight-six engines, two diesels and one range-topping petrol. News of the early demise of oil burners has been greatly exaggerated, don't you know? The diesel pair uses the same inline six-cylinder engine, tuned to varying degrees. The CLS 450 is the first model to debut the straight-six petrol engine with what Daimler calls EcoBoost, an additional electric starter generator motor driven by the new 48-volt electrical system, which harnesses energy under deceleration to provide up to 184 pounds-feet of additional torque to drive the car under full acceleration or while coasting throttle off. It's said to offer 8-cylinder performance for 6-pot penalty. This is familiar E-Class territory underneath, so we can probably predict with a high degree of certainty that the new CLS will be a comfort-oriented, high-tech drive. This is a good thing. We like the latest E, with its range of sensible, eco applications in company car spec diesel trim or its funkier, AMG-tuned D63 performance derivatives. There will, over time, be a CLS for most tastes and budgets. Air body control. Air suspension is an important option, offering drivers the chance to tweak the chassis settings to their choice of comfy float versus cast iron body control. Of course, the new 2018 CLS range will also make a good fit to driving itself. The journey to semi-autonomy is well underway here. Idle keep a set distance from the car in front, pull to a standstill in stop-start traffic and even slow down in anticipation of bends or speed limits ahead when in cruise control mode. If the worst comes to the worst, this car will bump you inwards if it anticipates a side collision and will even prepare your ears for the noise of an impact. Such is the onwards march of technological progress. Sales kick off in December 2017, with right-hand drive deliveries due in April 2018. Continental buyers can pick a highly specced first edition model, but this will not be offered in the UK,